Hi, Gaurav sir. Good morning. Welcome to the show. How are you, sir?
Hi, good morning. I'm well. How are you?
Yes, sir. Thank you for your time. And we look forward for more, such opportunity to have discussion on the markets. Sir, what's the view on the Nifty?
So, if you look at last couple of weeks and the way the Nifty has moved, it has become quite difficult to place proper levels for the reason that the momentum has been just one way up. We have not had a negative closings for last three consecutive days or maybe two consecutive days also. So that shows that the momentum is very strong in the Nifty index. And once Nifty crossed 14,000, it has all again with the kind of gap of opening we have had today, levels are again getting stretched. So on daily chart, it becomes difficult. Because markets are lifetime high, it's difficult to pinpoint where they're going to halt, whether it's going to be at 14, 200, 300, 500 win, right? So you go to a lower time frame to at least get the perspective at lower time frame, whether the trend is still holding up or not. Because on daily chart, you might still see some positivity. But the hourly charts, they will at least tell you whether the trend is still intact or whether we need to be a little bit cautious or not. So if you go to the hourly chart and if I use the Ichimoku setup over there, that tells me that once the Nifty crossed levels of 12,800 on the spot side, since then there is a component of Ichimoku that is called as Kijun. Nifty has not given an hourly close below that. Once it gave a move above levels of 12,800, 12,900. So that is very interesting. And that is what I would also be looking at. So cut is placed anything around levels of 13,950, 960. So any dip towards level of 14,000 can be bought into. That is a good support area. If you look at the option chain, 14,000 put option commands are very good concentration. So there's some comfortable writing in the put side as well. So anything towards 14,000 can be bought. Keep a 100-point stop loss. And again, on the upside, we can have a stretch of Nifty towards level of 14,250 to 14,280.
Right. Very interesting observation, sir. Sir, what do you think about Bank Nifty?
For Bank Nifty, more or less, if you see, it has been underperforming the Nifty index. We had a breakout in Nifty earlier, and then that was followed by Bank Nifty. Now, the critical supports are placed at levels of 31,000, because when Nifty moved above the levels of 13,800 something, we were still struggling when it came to Bank Nifty. And finally, Bank Nifty gave a move above levels of 31,000. It is still underperforming the Nifty index on daily and hourly charts. So that is a critical level. On the option chain, again, 31,000 put is witnessing some amount of selling on the weeklies. So that is going to act as a good support area. 31,550 on the spot side is the immediate hurdle. Right. If you look at the hourly charts, that was the last time also it dipped from these levels. So fresh breakouts on the hourly charts, once it gives a sustained move of 31,550, in which case we can have levels of 32,000 to 32,200, or you can buy on declines towards level of 31,000, keep again stop loss of 150 points and play for 7-8 kind of move. The reason that the levels are being emphasized, as I said, when the markets are at the stressed levels and it becomes difficult to say where they are going to stop, then we need to always focus on the lower time frame. So at least if things are not clear on the larger time frame, smaller time frame, let us tell you the proper entry and exits.
Right. Sir, any stock that is looking good on the charts?
So a lot of mid-cap names have seen breakouts, and I would like to share a few names with you. So first of that would be BEL in the defense area. And if you see, it has formed an inverse head and shoulder pattern, given a breakout above levels of 122, 123. The volume participation has been fantastic. It's also forming a proper Dow theory reversal. So in all likelihood, there's a possibility that it may go towards level of 140, 145. One can play with the stops of maybe 110 to 115. It's at 120, so now one can even keep a stop loss of 115 to 180, and 145 can be targets. It's been quite strong. Lal Path Lab is another name that is looking quite robust. It's a continuation pattern. So when I say continuation pattern, basically it witnesses a consolidation, range bound move, then a breakout, witnesses a sharp upside, again consolidation, and then again a breakout. So this is a continuation pattern. So again, there was a good breakout above levels of 2385, 2390. And it's quoting around those levels only. So one can keep a 50-60 point stop loss, and Lal Path can do levels of 2550. That is looking good. And one name, NCC. That is also quite interesting for the reason that It has been consolidating. Again, some breakout has been seen on daily chart. So there's a breakout about 61, 62. It's about those levels. Volume participation is also quite strong. So that can head towards the level of 68. Only keep a stop loss of 59 and be long in the name.
Right, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for your time.
Thank you. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to share my views.
Yes, sir. Looking forward for most of the opportunity. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Bye. Take care. Yeah.